لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I appreciate if you can give me one of each box. Jazakallah khair. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'm not going to discuss what I was going planning to talk to you in my way coming to here. For two reasons. You could not judge things from the outside. And I never been here, although I've been in South Carolina for 35 years, but for some reason I never know about the mosque here. And I apologize for this, for everybody. But it seems that some of you, a good number of you, had came already to Colombia and visited the mosque there. Thank you, appreciate this. Do you mind to pick up this also? Put this one on top of this one, please. Thank you.
This one?
Yes, sir. I appreciate this. You did good. See, this is my brother has all been helping me. So, alhamdulillah, some of you had visited the community there in Columbia and South Carolina, and I gave you official invitation to come to visit us. And I want to tell you one secret. Tomorrow, inshallah, this is the lasagna night. And people يضربون إليها يعني أكباد الإبل من كل مكان. Lasagna is a night that we, in every Ramadan, we cook lasagna. Although that, alhamdulillah, we have iftar for every night, and an average minimum of 160, 180 people eating. But in the lasagna night, you may talking about 400 people. And the lasagna dish is done by one of my wives. By my wife. What? Okay. Excuse me. So lasagna is a very good dish, and it is Germany and Puerto Rico and Spanish, and so it's have a combination. Italian also. And my wife have some kind of whatever, okay? So she make very good lasagna. So I'm inviting you, okay? We can add 50 people more for the dinner. Tomorrow is no big deal. Actually, what I was thinking to talk about something so was new to me. Alhamdulillah, I've been teaching in America for a minimum of 40 years. And alhamdulillah, I taught in the haram for about 2-3 years. Alhamdulillah, since I was a kid, I was teaching in Egypt, you understand? I gave my first khutbah when I was 12 years old. Alhamdulillah. But last night, I thought about something. Talk about fasting and fasting. What I was going to talk to you about fasting, but in a different way. One of the main things of fasting, abstaining from eating, drinking, relationship with the wives, and you know what's fair. But one of the main thing is what? To stay away from eating from dawn until sunset. Of course, it have with the intention of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because everything innama al-a'malu binniyat. If you don't have intention, or you're fasting so you can lose weight, it doesn't count with Allah. But you have to have the intention that you're doing this to obey Allah, to please Allah. But I noticed something about why this food, which is halal, is dhabiha, is bismillah, okay? But in certain time, it's become forbidden for us. And if you eat it, you'll be disobeying Allah. And I start to think about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he was wishing when he was in this life. And I start to think about eating and food. And I remember this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam making dua, not for having a Cadillac or a red camel or any of these things. Allahumma ja'al rizq ala Muhammad quta. It's amazing. The Prophet making dua concerning food and say, oh Allah, make the provision, the sustenance of the family of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be a qut. What is qut? This is not a type of food. That means it's something barely you can make it. That means maybe if you ate, you have breakfast, you could not have, you don't found a lunch. If you have lunch, there is no dinner. That means it's not going to be a leftover, neither are you going to be begging the people. So how is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in supplication and saying, oh Allah, make the provision and the sustenance of the people of Muhammad, not only Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, okay, he used to tie his stomach, okay, because there is no enough food. There is no food. A visitor will come to him, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent to his wife, I have a guest. Say, we don't have anything. The next one, I don't have anything. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will look to the companion and say, which one of you will entertain the guest of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? If the Prophet, the chief, the head of the believers, the messenger of Allah, and the best human being in the earth, he doesn't have something to entertain his guest, what about him? You see? So I start to think about this issue, and I was going to discuss it with you, but this will take until almost close to Suhoor to discuss it. Okay? And I know, time is finished already. I didn't even start. You see, you have to warm up first.
We'll give you 5 more minutes.
Five?
Seven
okay.
More.
All right, this sounds good. But basically, okay, plus tax, everything in America plus tax. Okay?
Yeah, I need 10 more minutes.
But you see, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam making dua, you found him all his dua related to the akhirah. Now I'm not talking food out of there is a word that I'm forgetting. I try to see. I was writing it while I'm sitting in the car. Okay. Allahumma inni as'aluka mujibati rahmatik. Okay. Most of the dua, if it's not all the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's concerned about the hereafter. Because this life, compared to the hereafter, like nothing. Like a person dip his finger on the ocean and he will take it out. How much your finger, how much water can stick to your finger out of this big ocean? This life compared to the hereafter, exactly. But be careful, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had make dua against the abd of the dollar. Dollar Akbar, huh? Some people say Allahu Akbar, and some people they say dollar Akbar. He said, Ta'isa Abdul Qatifa. Ta'isa Abdul Qatifa. Ta'isa Abdul Dirham. Ta'isa Abdul Dinar. Ta'isa Wantakas.
وإذا شئك فلنتقش. He making dua against a person who turned himself willingly with his own choice to be the slave of the suit. Became the slave of the car. Became the slave of the degree. Became the slave of the gold and the dollar. Nobody said you could not work or you could not go to school. But don't make this your whole aim in this life. When you give in yourself 8 hours every day inside the job and 2 hours going back and forth, this is 10 hours gone. And all these things, understand, not because of necessity, but you want to understand more. It's fine if everything is good in the house, if the kids are going to Islamic education, if you are providing, you understand, as Islamic adapt your children. Allah is saying, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Especially living in a place like in America. Compare the halal, the percentage of halal, and the munkar to the percentage of haram and munkar. You see? You found a drop. So mostly is haram. Mostly is munkar. Mostly is kufr. So we are in very wrong ground to raise children. So we need to turn our scale to the other side. So if you build all your effort, not only to have a minimum to, no. They said that Ali radiallahu anhu was working for a Jew, pulling water out of the well for one day, each bucket. He pulled three. And after this, say, okay, have a good day. Say, come, where are you going? I need more water. He say, no, this is it. 3 dates. He's going back. He's me. He's a cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the son of law of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 3 dates. He say, okay, I give you double. I give you triple. He said, no, this is enough. Okay. Most great number of the Sahaba, their name is what? Ahl Sufa. What is Ahl Sufa? Is exactly the same terminology that we say homeless. Great Sahaba, carrier, hafiz of Quran, they are homeless, sleeping in the backyard of the masjid. But their main concern is what? The Akhirah. Most of us now, we want, look, go to Arabia, go to some people, they dying to come to America, doesn't matter. Say, wallahi, I wish this is, I will do anything. We look to America to be Jannah, another for those A'la, for them, okay? But we say, where, how you going to provide for the children to make them grow in Islamic environment, to know what is halal and haram, to know what is sunnah and what is bid'ah. This is something very important, my brothers and sisters. So, من كانت الدنيا أكبر هم, became your main worry, is this dunya? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he make his poverty in front of his own eyes. And you're never going to get out of this dunya other than what Allah had decreed for you. So when you try to shorten a subject, you understand, for 2 minutes and 3 minutes, you may damage the subject and the people misunderstand what he's saying. Especially if you come in the first visit and now the people say, oh, this is say, don't go to school, don't work. Okay, we don't know, I want the sheikh, you understand, to come here. Not sheikh means the sheikh. Sheikh means wa abuna sheikhun kabir. Okay, the older man, you call him sheikh. This in terminology. So anyway, what I'm saying, let's at least balance our life. It's good to go to school. But let me give you an example. Our children today, or yesterday, or last week, they're out of school. Doesn't matter if Islamic school, Kafir school, public school. What program do we have for our children? How is he going to use the day? Everybody have a phone, cell phone. Everybody have Nintendo. Everybody have all these things. Huh? 2-3 months, our children, what's he going to be doing? Where is the programs? Where is the parents that are going to spend time with them? This is our future. This is the future of Islam. Me and you, we already gone. It's a matter of 5 years, 10 years, Allah knows best. But those are children. Those are the ones who are going to inherit this place. How's he going to run it? How's he going to act? So if we make an investment, we need to do investment on these children today. Education, Islamic education. Teaches them about Tawheed. Teaches them about La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. What is halal, what is haram. What is sunnah, what is bid'ah. What is kufr and what is iman. It's very important. So what I'm saying is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, most of his dua concerning the hereafter, about Jannah, about you understand that Allah be pleased with him. Okay? Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt. Tawallana fi man tawallayt. Barik lana. No, I didn't finish. Okay? Oh, you want another? Time. I got the hint.
Right.
Okay.
Right, yeah.
I think you got the idea. So basically, I understand since I only have 15 minutes more left, 15 seconds left. Don't worry, brother, I'm taking it. I want to introduce to you, inshallah, some of my work. And this is one of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah had blessed me, you understand, with it. This is some of my publication, okay? Called Adli Publication, which I do, to understand, to help the Muslims living in the United States especially, and they try, understand, to be a tailor, that you make a suit to suit the person. Not, you understand, you go to the market and get anyone, and after this, it's tall, short, and all these things. So I try to see the needs of the Muslim and do something to them, to help them. Doesn't matter if they are in the street, in their homes, or they are in the prison, if they are a new Muslims, or they are born Muslims, okay? As example, this is a book. Listen, brothers, let's be practical. Let's be realistic. Each one of us came to America, got something out of America and the American people. What did we give them back? Remember this. Some of you come get the master degree here, the PhD degree. They get, you understand, get a business and all these things. But don't we give them something back, other being citizen living here? We need to give them something, because we have something. We have it, they don't have it. And we have to care for them. Those what you call them, the kuffar in the street, we have to care for them. Allah telling us about the Prophet. You love the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah saying, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his sadness and feel bad about the kuffar is almost, this feeling is almost choking him, making him almost to suffocate, to die. Allah say, oh Muhammad, you're going to kill yourself forever worrying about these people? You see, we have to care for these people. So now, as example, one of these things, what we can give them. Brother, I don't know to give da'wah. I'm not sheikh. I'm not. Okay. Can we go to the flea market? Can we stand outside of the center once a week? Can we go on the street? Hey, good morning. How are you, ma'am? How are you, sir? Do you care for a book about Islam? Something. We need to give them some. Because some people say, I don't know how to talk to the people. How to start? At least take a booklet like this. Try give it. Can you imagine if you have a book like this and Allah guide one person through this effort? لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا. One, only one single person. Allah guide him through your effort. خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمْرِ النِّعَمِ. You be millionaire. You be millionaire in the blessings. Every time you say Allahu Akbar, read Fatiha, credit come to you. Exactly like what you're doing. He fast, you get a credit for his fasting. Why? We have to give da'wah. So somebody is not Muslim, you can give him this booklet, Islam. Somebody become Muslim, you teach him about Salah, one of the things about Salah. And this, alhamdulillah, one of the most successful book in United States and Canada about Salah, okay, with the picture, with the details, everything, all right? Look like me when I was young, huh? But it's okay, alhamdulillah. I'm still young inside, all right? This is wudu and Salah, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to give it to the new Muslim. Believe it or not, all of us need to look to this book. All right.
We need to give for it sisters. To some Muslims. We need to give it to some Muslims.
Yes, yeah, you're absolutely right. Some of this, as example, our sister, we have to care for them. So now I made a collection of authentic hadith, because a lot of fabricated hadith. Authentic hadith, 200 hadith for the Muslim sister. She need to know about her role and her duty to her husband, to her children, to his community, all these things. This is another book, all right, to serve the Muslim community. Advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 100 advice. This is khatira in the morning for 2 minutes. You read one hadith. You can have it in Arabic, you can have it in English. This is something good. You understand? Our children, okay. The last juz should work with them. And this is one of the tools that can help. If they don't know Arabic, they can read it in the phonetics. If they know Arabic and phonetics and English, they can know some of the tafsir. And alhamdulillah, this has also been designed for little kids. All right. Now, this one last thing I published, okay, is was idea how to make them interesting in learning the hadith. It's coloring, okay? You coloring the hadith, all right? You have pictures, okay? قل السلام عليكم أدخل okay and after this is say قل السلام عليكم written in phonetics and after this say the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم peace be upon him before you entering one must say السلام عليكم may I come in to teach him about the adab he's going to color you're going to say it in English say it in Arabic I made the book and after this I thought about the idea of doing what making competition for the children and I said to the children in my community anyone memorize this booklet will get a $50 In less than 1 week, I have 10 people waiting for me. And in action, they did it. They said in Arabic and they said in English. We can start a program like this, get, hey, something to color. And after this, tell them, listen, if you know how to say it, you're going to get $50. You're going to get $20. A prize, anything. So this is something also about, I don't know how many, 32 hadiths or something like this. Youth, mashallah, we have young. Okay, something related to the youth, okay? This is also selection of hadith for the youth. Learning Arabic, even if you don't know anything, for adult, for children, okay? Make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep me on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And the bomb for all United States and Canada, the Bid'ah book, all right? So doesn't matter you come from overseas or you grow in Guyana or in Africa, wherever, you're going to need to read this book, okay? And before you curse me out, try to make sure that you are not wrong, that I'm wrong, okay? Because nobody will like this. And as soon as he reads this, say, we don't need this sheikh in our masjid anymore. But I'm a free da'iyah. I'm not worried about people loving me or hating me. I'm worried about delivering the message, okay? This talks about bid'ah. Doesn't matter, you're overseas, or in America, or in Africa. You hear it. The unique thing about it, it talks to you about the bid'ah for reading Quran, bid'ah in Ramadan, bid'ah in Hajj, bid'ah when somebody died, okay? It's in the book. Methodology, okay? Alhamdulillah, I have about 48 books and more coming inshallah and I pray that the last book that I do before I die that the book that say get to know more about Allah so now my brothers and sisters because mostly sisters hold their checkbook of the brothers okay these books I'm not going to sell it we could not sell here in the masjid but I tell you one thing I'm going to do this I brought you only half bucks each with exception wudu and salah and Islam aids because you need to do this and go and say, give more and give it more. If you need more, I send it. But I'm going to give this free to this community. Wait for the tricks now. There is a trick coming. With the trick, I'm saying give you gift. وَكَانَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَقْبَلُ الْهَدِيَّةِ وَكَانَ يُثِيبُ عَلَيْهَا The Prophet ﷺ used to what? Accept the gift. And he used to reward the person who gave him the gift. So you give me 5, I give you 10. So we need to learn this sunnah. Yeah, after Isha, we're making sunnah, Qiyam al-Layl, we're making water. So now I want your sunnah today. For me, you gave me money, you don't give me money, it's fine. This is yours. All these 12 or 10 boxes, this is yours. A gift from Adli Publication, inshallah. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it sincere for his pleasure. Now, inshallah, it's up to the imam how to distribute it. But mashallah, there is enough for everybody, even those who did not come tonight, they come for Jum'ah. That every person can get a set. This set that you're going to get, why about 11, 12 books, is at least $50. Okay? Okay? So inshallah, I'm giving you a gift. And I'm telling you the sunnah that you reward who's giving the gift by returning something in a better way. So I'm asking you to assist me in my endeavor and my mission that I'm doing. I'm not funded by any country for your knowledge, okay? I'm not funded by my mosque. I'm not funded by anybody. I'm only one individual work. I work hard, okay? And I try my best because when I die, I could not make books. I could not teach. I could not preach. So inshallah, if any one of you would like to help fi sabilillah to spread the knowledge and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I would like to see if somebody would like to give $1,000 for this course inshallah, fi sabilillah. For printing, for reprinting, for adding more books, if anybody can give $1,000 fi sabilillah. Anybody? Bismillah. Allahumma a'ti munfiqan khalafa. Every day in the morning, two angels come, especially to make dua. The one angel will say what? Oh Allah, give the one who spent it in your cause, return, multiply it for him. While the other angel is saying what? Allahumma a'ti mumsikan talafa. The one who withhold, spoil his property. So you don't want the other angel to make dua against you. Anybody can give $1,000 in the cause of Allah. We send the books free to the postage. My postage last year was $3,000. We said because I could not get money from the prison, neither they can pay for the stamp, so I have to send. And everybody knows the Adli publication, they want. We send it to them. People, they want to give da'wah, flea market, we give the people boxes. So inshallah, your contribution, this is what is going to be for you in the day of the judgment. Since $1,000 is so big for you guys, two people can get together and make $1,000. Which two people, inshallah, will come for 500 each? Okay, let's see who's going to raise his hand first. I hope it's not a sister now. I could not see the sisters from here. Anybody would like to contribute $500 towards this cause? This is alhamdulillah, brother. May Allah reward you. May Allah reward you. Anybody would like to give $500, inshallah, for this cause? Will be the first one to lead in good cause, inshallah. Is it too much for you to give $500? $500. Allahu Akbar. Allahu, I told you guys, I told you. May Allah reward you. May Allah give you better than what you spend. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you to be a leader in the good deed, inshallah. Don't think that women could not do.
Her mom and her daughters are inside.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, bless your family. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue blessing you. And I'm going, I know I don't do this, but I'm doing it only specially for this sister. I'm going to sign this booklet called 200 Hadiths for a Muslim Sister. I hope.
Hussein.
Huh? MashaAllah. What's happened to my pen? Okay, here.
Give him the name, he's going to sign the book for her.
Husni Arabiga.
Brother, this is, may Allah bless it, inshallah. Come on, brothers, $500. Anybody would like to give $500 for this cause? You slow down, another sister will get up and say $500. Don't do this, I feel embarrassed now. Please, hurry up before another sister give $500. $500. All right, what about if we ask that you buy one box for $300? This box costs $600 and more. Some of them $7. This book, $7. This book is $3. This book is $5. Okay? Brothers, I'm giving you, hey, you could not buy me a tea. I came to your community. You could not buy and some dinner for me. This, okay? Who's going to give you, inshallah, $300 for one box? Oh, I forgot. I donate this box. I could not sell it. I'm sorry. This, okay. I'm sorry. It's my mistake. Anybody would like to give $200? $200. Come on now. Who broke it down? Okay? $200.
Got it
right
there.
See? Right there. $200. Brother Abdul Razak. MashaAllah. May Allah reward you and make you a leader in the good, inshallah. Be a means of good. So the Sheikh start with $200. Who's going to go after him? Come on. $200. You can do. May Allah reward you.
Another $200.
Okay, so he wants to start the salah.
Two and two, 400, Sheikh. Wait, 200 more, $1,000 from all of
you. Okay.
Okay.
I lift it. Okay. Zakumullah khair. May Allah reward you. And I will give you a free event for tonight. Zakumullah khair. May Allah reward you, inshallah. Zakumullah khair. I will give you a free event tonight. What do you think about this?
Yalla, bismillah.
Zakumullah khair. Tabi Sheikh. Barakallahu feekum, subhanakallahu wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta.